person, like cruises. I don't understand people that do cruises. I get people like them, and that's great. For me, I have zero interest. I think the only way you'd get me on a cruise, it'd have to be like, you know, Alaska or like Antarctica or something like that. You know, something like super, super unique. Or like, I'm not going to go on a cruise in the Bahamas. Like, I have no interest in ever doing that. So,
you know, I've never been on a cruise either. And I was interested in going on one potentially, but then I watched this video the other day by there's this guy. I found him recently. I highly recommend you check him out. And everyone listening, go check this guy out. On YouTube, there's a guy called Ordinary Things. He's a British guy that basically does very kind of like sarcastic Charlie Brooker-esque kind of videos where he just talks about anything from like the popularity, rise and fall of fedora hats, or the death of Ronald McDonald, or, you know, what else is it? The soda, like, you know, the Coca-Cola and soda. And he did one on cruise ships. And it just put the fear of God in me. I never realized that even pre-COVID, cruise ships like is one of the hot spots for catching diseases and stuff. And well, diseases, but like illnesses. And they actually have like these massive banners and advertisements when you're on the ships that say like, oh, wash your hands all the time. You know what I mean? And like, because people just often get, you know, and I suppose it makes sense. You're out at sea, you know, you're stuck with a bunch of people and, you know, you're probably prone to getting things like flu and but it's just disgusting. Like this idea that people don't wash their hands or take care of their personal hygiene and stuff. And you're essentially like in a small container where you're literally contained with these people.
It's like a floating petri dish, essentially. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. It's like, oh my God. But and then I also saw some small videos showing like, you know, the difference between what's sold to you maybe in a travel brochure and then the reality. So obviously in the travel brochures you see, oh look, these lovely deckings, and you know you're in the sun and you're on a stretcher by the water and it's all lovely and there's barely anyone around. But the reality is there's like 200 people in the same area and it's packed and you could barely move. Like, I don't know, that's my idea of fucking nightmare right there. Like I want to get as far away from people as possible if I'm on holiday.
When you travel, I mean you want to do something unique and something that you enjoy. I mean I understand the people that enjoy cruises and I get it, because it's just, you know, I pay you money and I don't have to think about the rest of it. But for me personally, that's just not the way I want to travel. I mean I would never recommend it to everybody, but to each their own, I guess, kind of on that front.